Hello everybody, welcome to the Wednesday afternoon or evening stream. It's like tea time-ish, it's 22 minutes past 6, I think, something like that. And we're back on Divinity Original Sin, and as normal I just need to just change the option again, because I've got the line. I don't know why it happens, not a clue. Done it. Right, where were we? Right, we were in Black Cove, I believe, and we were about to go through the Black Ominous Gate. So we will do that now. And make our way down. Anything of interest here? I don't think there is. I think when we finish the Black Cove, we need to go back to town for a starter. We need to turn that in. We need to do that one. And that one. Oh, so we've got quite a bit to turn in and get experience from. Alright, mice, come here. Let me have a word.
One of Rivalon's most ancient creatures.
I'd wager someone or something made mad and mighty by source.
I think you might be right there, Scarlet. Anything over here? Oh, and there is one alteration from last episode. You might have noticed I've added Medora and taken Jahan out. Thought we'd give it a whirl, see how we go from there. Right, where are we going? Across here, I think. Yep. There's nothing up this way, is there, that I can get to? No. Always wary of missing a secret or so.
We're on the hunt for something capable of taking out not one, but two dragons.
Oh dear.
Delight of delights.
Anything over here? No. And we know what's coming here, don't we? Oh, there we go. Always makes me jump.
Do you suppose that's what destroyed those dragons?
I think it probably is.
How can I suppose anything with those eyes sizing me up like so much rump roast?
Right, you
it's
need to get
It's drawing
up there.
Water from the sea.
It'll use it against us unless we can stop it.
Amplified clarity!
Alright, let's see how we do. Only one shot. Bear daughter, is that it? Alright, do you want to put spider on spider? Yes, we do. Just retreat slightly. If that will work. It's a bit close to me, that. No. Target is blocked. Great. I'll whack it off. There we go. Right. Get in there, Medora, and tank this little thing here. What We're using fire damage, so that should be alright. Let's try that. Ah, it's not bad damage, not bad. Wait, no. Don't be nasty. No. Alrighty then. Right, we need to try and freeze her, I think, or something. Will wheat work? Oh yeah, wheat works. Okay. And she doesn't look too happy about that. Another attack, thank you very much. Oh, damn it. Oh, here we go again. Right, okay. What have we got? Freeze arrow. Freezing failed. Let's try again. Chilled. Oh, damn it. What have we got here? Well, charm isn't going to do anything. Need 2 minutes to use that. Let's buff up my door a little bit. And bless my bear daughter.
My prayers prevail!
Can we knock it down? I don't think we can, but we'll try.
May the 13 winds pulverize you.
Immune to knockdown. Bitter cold. Right, already chilled, so I should freeze it. Yes.
Yeah, welcome you.
Get out of my way. Ouch. And ouch again. Right, let's try and get rid of you. Only one shot, great. Staff, what are we using? Fire, that's alright. That's him gone. Right, come on, Bedora. Thank you. I don't like using that, but we will do. Fire damage, only doesn't unfreeze her. No. Anything else we can use? No. Slowly and surely we get there. Oh, that was pathetic. have you got anything else? What else have we got here? Oh, we can buff up my door off a bit more. Oh, this freezer lasting a long time. Oh, yes! Critical hit. Bye-bye, Spidey. Nice one. What have we got? Throw a little heal down there.
Back on my heel there.
Excuse me. Got a bit of a cold, I'm sorry. So if I'm sniffing and coughing and grunting. Right, what have they dropped for us? A sea spider's claw. That's a new one. I've never seen that before.
Treasure!
Sam's collar. And that's it. Let's have a look. Purple ring. That's always nice. First resistance one lockpicking. Let's send that to Bear Daughter. One Lore Master. No, we've got the Lore Master on this save. One on there. None. Ah, there we go, it's Scarlet. Throw that over, in case it's better than what she's got. We're not using daggers, but we'll send it to Bear Daughter just in case. Hmm, 12 HP, 38 armor rating. Let's see if Scarlet will use it. Crushing Fist, we already have. Might as well do this while we're here. Oh, I haven't got enough crafting to do it. Great. Right. What's next? Oh, need to check that, don't I? Don't run off, Nick, without doing what you're supposed to do. 38, 40. Well, she don't need perception. What's Bear Daughter got? Dexterity perception and lock picking. We've got loads of perception rings here. And lock picking rings, right, okay, she can keep all these. Well, she doesn't need that, does she? No. No, she's already got perception rings on, she doesn't need it. So we can sell those.
What's this? I found something.
Treasure. One strength. Two Medora. Oh, pardon me. And she hasn't got one on, so that is lovely. -43 to -74, exile the same, so Roderick can have that to sell. Hello, Desdemona.
Your flesh. Why, you're positively radiating. It's been years since a warm blood has wandered through these caverns. An utterly lovely sight.
I met Samson's ghost at the lighthouse. He's filled with regret after having purposely sunk your ship.
He could never. You mean to say he left us to those savage waters on purpose? I can't believe it. And yet, if what you say is true, well, I must meet him in any case. To the lighthouse, you said? Fine.
Well, okay. I don't think there's anything else here to do. I think we've done it all. If I have missed anything, let me know in the comments, please. I'm hoping I haven't. I don't think I have. What's up here? No. Right, okay, let's head to the lighthouse. desolated farms. Head into the lighthouse and see what Desdemona's got to say. I really do need to move the raptor twitch thing. It gets in the way there a bit. I need to put it down here somewhere, I think. I'm using Raptor to stream, by the way. It's really easy for streaming to Twitch when I'm playing a game. It's just like one button press, rather than using OBS and going through all the rigmarole of that.
My love, I should have known you would never betray me. I should have known your love to be as constant as the sky. Madness took hold of my heart, and with razor nails scratched murderous intent into its depths. And yet, look at us now. Not even death could impede our reunion. I beg of you, my love, forgive me. With but a word, you can heal my heart, efface the scars that lunacy left there. Forgive me, my wife, my own. Forgive me.
You've heard the whole story by now. Perhaps you can help me settle my mind. Half of me is furious, and the other half is utterly enraged. What do you think of my murderer husband?
Two choices again. Sansa's truly repentant. Desdemona ought to forgive him so they could both move on. Or Desdemona is under no obligation to forgive a murderer, no matter how sorry he may be. I know she's under no obligation, but it would be nice if they could go away together. Let's do
indeed
that.
Indeed. Samson committed a terrible deed, but I've never seen one so utterly filled with regret.
I suppose you're right. The deed is done, and I can do naught but move forward now. Samson, I do forgive you. I do.
Bless your shining soul, my love. From its incomparable purity, even the diamond hides its dull complexion in shame. The nightmare is at an end. We are together again, and shall remain so evermore.
Yes, the past is the past, my darling. Let's go forward together now, hand in hand into the next life.
Okay. So that one's finished. Lost love at the lighthouse. All done and dusted. Okay, so we've got Kitty Luff, Cecil's Mighty Staff. I think we got that. Yes, I'm sure we did. I'm not sold it over. No, it's Johan's quarterstaff. Oh, I won't give it to Johan, have I? To use. I'll bet you I did. Okay, let's have a quick mosey to the end of time while I check this. Right, okay, we have a conversation going.
I need a moment to reflect.
I never considered myself a compassionate sort, but our recent work has proven otherwise.
You've grown quite compassionate indeed.
Okay, end. Thank you. Get rid of that. Come on, boys and girls. Into the Hall of Heroes, please. I should be able to... Oh no, Johan's got those on. So what have I done with it? well, if you'd looked there in the first place, Nick, you would have known that you had it all along. Northgate. I amaze even myself sometimes. Alright, what's the first one we need to do? Get your love. And have we got something to replace that? 29 to 57 fire. Got nobody using wands now, so I wonder if I could use wands on him. Got your hands quarter staff. Oh, I got that, that's better anyway. Put that in. Hello, Unsinkable Sam.
Where's a young Esmeralda these days? She has the softest lap to lay in. I am Unsinkable Sam. At least that's what they call me around here. Used to be a magnificent ship, she
okay,
was.
The moment
I hit the water, I rust so I was. What friends I had. Not that I have it bad here. Winking. Whiskers. You found my collar? Oh, thank you. Bless you. I shall don it right this instant, and hie me to Maxine as fast as my paws can carry me.
There we go.
Aaron has as many friends as the man with many chases.
Maxine, my love, look at me. I am wearing it. The collar I told you about, the one you told me was but the fancy of a dream. Here it is. A band of jewels, such as no one in Cyseal has ever beheld.
Dear me, but that choker looks absolutely fabulous on you. Simply smashing.
She's not even looking at him.
Real. Oh, darling Sam, you are a Tom of Means after all.
That I am, my little tigress. Behold my true color and marry me. Make me yours, and my very life I shall dedicate to your happiness.
Oh, what a passionate puss you are, my darling Sam, as impetuous as ever. But indeed you do seem to have the right and reason to be. Oh, I shall hold you in suspense no longer. Yes, my dear Sam, I will marry you.
With a word, you have stopped my heart and set it beating anew with untold vigor. Come. My love, my lean-tailed lady. By the fire of the hearth, let us lie and purr the night away.
Okay. Quick word here.
And so Sam's story has a happy end after all. What a cynical thing to say. She loved him all along, but was worried about the children they might have. That's quite another matter.
Okay, right. It appears I haven't robbed this dude, so very quickly.
What?
Right, just talk to him
a
minute.
Again. Please tell me how I can help you during your investigations. I know your plate is full enough to fill you for days.
Oh, I have already robbed him. It just appeared that I hadn't. Right. Okay. Sorry about that, folks. Right, here we go. Here we go.
Wait here. I'll get my beekeepers. Oh, wait. Oh, yes. They just informed me that they cleared the cave.
That's the Fabulous Five.
Presents, so I gave them the reward as promised. They just left town. The rest of the world needs saving, too. Oh, they truly are.
Yes, they truly are fabulously lying little shits. Excuse my language. Right, take my leave, thank you. And hello, Charlene.
Hello again, adventurer. I hope you wiped those muddy boots on your way in.
I've learned of Tom's fate.
You say you met him. Was he well? Did he look hungry to you? Cold? Was he eating enough vegetables? Did he wash his hands before supper?
Oh, dear.
Oh, please, you must tell me everything you know.
Oh, dear, dear, dear. Do I tell the truth? Or do I lie? Tell the truth.
Yes, It's a bitter truth, but one we can't conscionably keep to ourselves.
I can't. That's impossible. You must be mistaken. Tom was a daring boy, but an adroit one too. Check your facts before you spread such horrible lies. Tom's alive. Do you hear me?
Oh, dear. That's Tom Dunfactor's five, Kitty Love. Cecil's mighty staff.
What? Oh, hello again. Please tell me how I can help you during your investigations. I know your plate is full enough to fill you for my elf. What elf? Oh, myself. I am Cecil. What? Oh, you mean Cy, the undead of Over? That's not to mention that at the top of this hole, Commander.
Oh, here we go.
While we're on the subject of troubles, I myself have a private matter I'd like to bring to your attention. It involves a magic relic, rather foolishly sought. A weapon called the Staff of Pergamon.
Oh, what's this about the Staff of Pergamon?
What of what now? Oh, you're speaking gibberish. Ah, you mean the Staff of Pergamon. Yes, yes. I was expecting a shipment of weapons, and among the cargo was this very powerful, very rare staff. I managed to place the order through means somewhat, atypical to a government official. Cecil proved an old fool, though. For the merchant slated to deliver it to me has just informed me that the damn thing has gone missing. I fear it may have fallen into the wrong hands, and I wonder if you could retrieve it for me.
Okay, here you go.
What? You found it? Oh, this is excellent news. Where is it then? Give it here.
I could keep it if I wanted to. No, we'll give
it. Careful that it doesn't wind up in the wrong hands again, Mr. Mayor.
Wonderful. Oh, it's simply wonderful. Come, come. You must let me thank you somehow. I've got it. A 3 months honorary membership to the Sycial
really?
Library.
Okay, I'll take your leave. Thank you. What else have we got?
I knew that dark dealing old man dabbled in source.
To the gallows. Who's failed the experiment?
The gallows? Well, I've heard of such a thing, but I've never seen one myself. I don't think I care to either.
Which will be. Let me think. That will be in the headquarters. Yes. We had one survivor, I think, from the experiment, did we? Yeah, just one of the fighting men, yes. Turning these in could get us quite close to dinging.
Sorry, sir.
Which would be very nice.
Sorry, sir.
Victorious.
It's
yes.
You! Fantastic! You'll never guess what happened after you helped me out of that cave. I came back to Sycial to recuperate, and Lieutenant Selenia caught wind of my tale. She called me a brave man and set me up as a legionnaire guarding this very treasure room.
Might let him into that treasure room. I could take advantage of him here.
You want to enter? I don't know. My sole responsibility is to keep people out.
But I'm not going to. I'm going to play this playthrough pretty nicely, I think. I'll take my leave, and that should be that one done. Yes. Stopples flashing. What else we got? Oh, we haven't got Headless Nick yet. Really? Let us rectify that mistake right away, because we're quite close to where we need to go. Here we go.
Commander!
Come one! Come all! Can't you?
A quick word with Cedric.
You there! Sit! Stay a while! Right in front. I'll excite you. I'll delight you. I'll beguile you. I'll besmile you. I'm Cedric the Sensational, and I'm playing to an empty audience. Don't pity me. No, sir. Just a few years ago, I was the all-singing, all-dancing, all-sensational darling of the town. People came from far and wide just to witness my amazing act. When Reginald came, he brought some fantastic prop with him. Now, have you seen it? A talking head. Now, I never expected a silly gimmick like that to be my main competition.
Tell me about the competition between you and Reginald.
It seems even my usually choosy audience has been taken in by that hack's little gizmo. I'm a man of skill, sleight of hand, feats of wit, and pure entertainment. This curio is ruining what used to be an art. And even when there's no crowd to speak of, old Reggie still has at least one fan calling bravo and hee-haw. Sure as the sun sets, that one devotee attracts five more, and those five more all curious about the commotion. I don't know how he inspires such loyalty with less talent contained between his hat and his boots than I've in my crusty handkerchief.
Oh dear. Okay, I'll take my leave, thank you. Right. Let us go and have a word. Hello, Reginald.
You there! Take a seat! Prepare to laugh your head off! Cry your eyes out! And teeter on the edge of your seat with an original tale from Stefan, the talking severed head!
Let's discuss your competition, Cedric.
Yes, I know of that talentless bull. He was here entertaining the troops before I was brought in. I'm sure the hack simply bored his audience to tears until they cried for a replacement. Enter Reginald the Illusionist! We need our boys in red happy, relaxed, and ready to fight! Not wasting their energies cringing at a fool with a depressed rabbit in a borrowed hat.
Okay, I'll take my leave. Let's have a quick word with Gallagher.
What are you looking at me for? There's a great show going on right in front of you. And look! There stands the world-famous Reginald the Entertainer. Better check it out if you don't want to miss the time of your life. I'm nothing but your average man taking in the best show I've ever seen. I'm amazed and astounded that for a meager gold coin or two, I can take in this first-rate entertainment all day long.
Same show all day, that seems a bit much.
Well, I've stumbled into quite the fine gig. I just let my appreciation for Reggie's work be known, and he slips me a few gold coins in return. My voice happens to carry pretty far. Cycile hears me. Cycile wants to see what the fuss is all about. And let me tell you, this amazing show just can't be beat.
Okay, take my leave a little bit. Warming the crowd, there we go. Right, so a quick word with Cedric. To tell him what his competition is doing. Using a crowd warmer to get the crowd in.
A familiar face. Come, watch the show. I promise it'll take your mind off beheading baddies. Or whatever it is you do with all those muscles.
I mean, you heard Reginald uses a crowd warmer.
I, a person whose sole job is to praise the performance and stir a crowd. A genius invention. No wonder Reginald has had such success. I knew his act couldn't have outshone mine on its merits alone. Please, you must hire him for me. Imagine the scowl on that con man's face when my rightful audience returns to me. A must-see event.
Okay, I'll take my leave. Right, I'm back again. Excuse me. Right, a little quick save here. Because depending on how the conversation goes and the rock, paper, scissors, I might have to reload in order to do this.
What are you looking at me for? There's a great show going on right in front of you. And look, there stands the world famous.
Alright, you've already said
Reginald
that. Would you be interested in warming up the crowd for Cedric over there?
Well, I don't see why I should. Reginald and I have grown rather friendly, you know? And in any case, it'll be hard to pull myself away from this fantastic show.
I suppose a professional like you would have enjoyed the challenge. Here we go. Oh, 5-2. Wow. Okay. Well, let's start Rock.
My word!
Scissors.
Fantastic!
Rock. Damn it!
My word!
You there! You don't look like someone who's ever
really
been serenaded by a severed head!
My word!
Oh, no, that's cheating. That is cheating big style.
I don't need to prove a thing.
Okay, let's reload that.
Bravo! Yeehaw!
Dear. Alright.
What are you looking at me for? Well, I don't see why I should. Reginald and I have grown rather friendly, you know? And in any case, it'll be hard to pull myself away from this fantastic show!
Really?
Ha! Fantastic!
It's ridiculous.
You there! You don't look like someone who's ever been serenaded by a severed head.
Word.
Step right up!
Fantastic!
There we go. Wow. Thank you.
Well, I guess it's been long enough since I've stretched my wings a bit, and it ain't so far of a flight now, is it? Maybe I will have a peek at what Cedric's up to over there.
Before you go, nothing of any interest.
It is said, and this I have heard from a ghost who knew Elba, who knew Elliot, who is said to have known...
Well, all these should walk away when he gets over there. There is another little quest that you could do here where you can talk to this lady, then you pick up some books from the library where you can perform a one-man show or a two-man show. You talk to this guy, you perform it, and they come over to you and applaud you if you do it right. There we go, but I really don't think we need to do that.
What? Where is everyone trotting off to? Don't they want to hear how the story ends?
Strange! You appear to be my only client! Aye, these Sicilian cows wouldn't dare chew their cud without the full support of the herd. Without my crowd warmer, I can't attract a crowd for the life of me.
How about your competition, Cedric?
I knew that fool could never have garnered so much as a guffaw on his own merits. I'll see to this matter immediately.
Bye-bye. See you later, Reginald. All right, we're now going to take your head.
Do re mi fa sol la ti. Oh, excuse me, I'm trying to prepare for the next show. I doubt I have to tell you that I am the amazing singing Stefan, the only sentient severed head in Sicil. My audience sings my praises from hill and dale. Psst, you're a source hunter, aren't you? Oh, bless the seven. Look, you've got to help me. I've been kidnapped. Pleasure to meet you. Now, please, Stefan has many fans to meet today. Psst, help me. Take me to Reginald's cellar. There I will reveal everything.
Okay.
It won't be the worst indignation I've suffered.
I don't think we need to go to Reginald's cellar, but... Might as well. He's asked us to do it. Let's do it. I think we could really go straight to the body, but I'm not, we might miss out on a little bit of experience, so let's see if that key is here. There we go. Reginald's key. And there's a mound there.
Something.
Don't ever, ever dig that up without saving first, because it will explode on you. There we go. Into the cellar.
Ah, a little privacy at last. Out of earshot of that contemptible jester, we can finally speak freely. My true name is Nick. In life, I was an entertainer aboard the ship of the famed Pontius Pirate. I once dared to defy him, and he savagely beheaded me for the attempt. Little did I know the abuse was only beginning. A wandering sorcerer, mad as the day is long, found my severed head on the beach and resurrected me. I spent months in his company listening to him blather on about his every inane opinion. When I asked him to return my head to my body, it must be in the Black Cove still, he became enraged and tossed my head into the sea. Reginald stumbled upon me some days later and consigned me into his horrid little show. I know not how long I've been entertaining slack-jawed imbeciles at the Sicile Fair. All I know is I just can't take you anymore.
So you want to be reunited with your body then?
More than anything.
Oh, there we go.
But the chances are so slim with the Black Cove utterly infested with Pontius's undead cronies. My poor lost body is among them, sightless and silent in their vile company. For all I know, they're using it as a coat rack. Traveller, if there were any way you would brave the Cove's depths and reunite me with myself, you'd be doing me the only kindness I'd have received in as long as my poor memory serves.
Okay, if you're ready, I'm going to pick you up now. You won't mind a little ride in my pocket, will you?
It won't be the worst indignation I've suffered. Get on with it, then.
Okay. And derelict harbour. There we go.
The body stirs. The subtle slouch in its decayed shoulders suggest intense longing. A large, soggy chunk of flesh falls to the ship's floor with a melancholic thud.
Ew.
So this is what's to become of me, it seems to moan. A body with no head. A ship with no captain.
So what about your head?
Nick's body grows cold, then hot. Could it be, after all this time, reunited? Could it be real? Could it be true? Tremors overtake its hands, its knees, and then...
Toes? Legs? Arms? Fingers? A bit more rotten than when I last saw them, but who am I to look a gift self in the mouth? Oh, the feeling of air in my minimally perforated lungs. well, not quite blood, but lovely ooze pumping through my only moderately decayed veins. What a joy it is, my friend! What an absolute joy! Now for my last unfinished business. Pontius Pirate, the animal who consigned me to the peanut-crunching masses. I won't rest until his skull cracks beneath my foot.
Sorry to burst your bubble, but Pontius is already dead.
Dead? Dead and dead for good? Never to rise again? You're very certain? Well, I would have loved to see him collapse to dust myself, but your assurance is most satisfactory. With my head back on my shoulders and my foes defeated, I owe you a large debt of gratitude, my friend. Here is my pledge to you, then. Your enemies from now and forevermore shall be as my own. Call me when you will, where you will, and I will fight beside you. I'm dying to try out my right hook, now that I've got arms again after all. Until we meet again, Source Hunter, I remain your humble bodyguard, eager for your summons.
Anything for us? No. Oh, there we go.
It was Source that drove Pontius mad. Yet it is Source that has kept Nick alive to fight his old foe.
Two choices again. Nick may now be our ally, but no mistake, he's better off dead than perverted into unlife by Source. Or, though we are sworn to eliminate it, there is more to Source than simple evil.
Indeed. The Academy taught us far from all there is to know about this strange magic.
Renegade. Right. Decisions. Who's going to get Nick? I think we'll give it to Roderick. I think so. Scarlet will be getting the ice pet and the fire pet. Oh, for the time being though, I could give it to her. Because Roderick's already got the spider. Then we're going to have two creatures. Send to Scarlet. We need to clear a space. Or shall we move? No, I'll take what we'll put it there, shall we? Learn skill. There we go. Summon Zombie Nick. Zombie me. Right, so what have we got left? Headless Nick done, Warm in the Crowd done, our Who's Filled Experiment done. Have we been out of the North Gate yet? I mean the proper gate, not the empty gate. Right, first of all, we need to do a save. We haven't saved in a while. And I will actually do a proper save for this. After Nick. There we go. Yes, we have already been out this way, so how far did we get? Okay, we need to go into the shrine and have a word with Evelyn, I do believe. Yes, we do. We do indeed.
Beyond these walls, the dead roam free, Hunter. Be vigilant.
I think we got rid of all these here, did we? Did we do the fight here? Yes, we did. All these dead people around us, so obviously we did. Right. What are you doing, Nick? What are you doing? Secluded beach. Really? Why are you running when you don't need to? We've already done the Watcher statues. Yes, I think we have. Yes.
This seems to be the location mentioned in Evelyn's diary.
Okay.
It looks like it, but where's the entrance?
Well, we need to use... if I can find it in all my junk reveal spell.
Didn't you read the spell, my friend? We who step through yonder gate, the hunters hate, eh? Doesn't sound like your sort of crowd, does it?
He's Welsh.
Councillor's corpses lying around, Pritchard.
Don't let's worry about that just now, my friend. Hmm? Why don't you step away from that gate and we can while away the afternoon with such matters? But most certainly, though I haven't practiced in quite some years, all the ferocity and fire of it just can't hold my interest the way a mellow afternoon on the beach can. You're giving me a strange sort of look, my friend. Is the heat getting to you?
See, the thing is, we're sorcerer and we are source hunters. Conclusion, we kill you.
So we shall. Sorry, buddy, but your day in the sun is over.
As you wish, source hunter. I may be retired, but don't think for a moment I've lost a modicum of my skill. The beach will be so much less pleasant with your rotting corpse attracting every gull and maggot in Sicile.
Okay. Why is he flapping his arms like a chicken? And he goes invisible. Where does that invisible go? Forward. Right, so... if we take that, I might hit him. Let's, how many does it take, that? 7 to use. So I can come forward to there. And I can hit all of them. And him. That's what I wanted. To bring him out. Go on, Nick. Do your stuff. Let's try and knock you down.
Rush and fist.
Knockdown failed. Didn't that time, oh, did it? Ouch. Oh, where are you going? Get out another companion. Kill you. Oh well, that's even better.
I think I'll go for the eyes this time.
Ooh, I nearly killed it. No. No. Please tell me you've got something. No, 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 no. the fact that she's charmed. That is nasty. Well, she's stunned anyway. That should help.
Stand down before I put you down.
What do you think, Source Hunter? Shall I start shredding from the top or the bottom?
Oh, that's nice damage. Nice damage. And he's stunned. Getting a bit stuttery at the game at the moment. I don't know what's going on here. Fire damage. Let's see if that'll do it.
Wrath of the Magi!
Doesn't appear so. Damn it.
Stave of combat.
Decaying touch failed. Great. That is what we wanted. Medora is right with us. Not sure what good that will do, but no, I don't think it'd do much. Not on those.
I'll make short work of this scam.
Oh, come on now. Hooray, Medora gets a go. Diverman, there we go. Right, any healing to be done? Just a tad. Sorry, Medora, I think it was me that did that damage to you. But I had to stop you from attacking Guz. Right, a quick word with Bear Daughter.
My friend, we have done it! The secret lair of Evelyn is before us at last. I will follow where you lead, into this mystery, and out the other side of it too.
Ah, oh, thank you, Bear Daughter. Very kind of you. Right, what have we got here? Lots of unidentified stuff.
Now this is valuable.
Mug of beer, bread, cheese. No, I'm not interested. Really? A pitchfork. Sell it. There we go. And I think that will bring us to the end, folks, for this episode. We will go into Eelin's Lair next time. Thanks for watching. Don't forget, if you do like the videos, please leave me a like and subscribe. This is Ogre, signing off.